Friday race fans, and welcome to Talladega Super Speedway and tonight's coverage of the Crow's Nest SS Series here from Talladega for 100 laps here tonight, as we've got about 9 minutes left of a practice on the board. Let's take a look at the point standings as they come to Talladega here this evening on Extreme Sim TV. As always, I'm glad to be out here with you tonight. Let's turn up my audio a little bit. Make sure you guys can hear me really well. And let's take a look here at your point standings coming into this one with two races remaining in the series. Dave Lane out front, 22 back. Michael Spell, Dwight Plesch, 43 back. Vasquez, 49 back. Ken, 59 back. Peck is 84 back, and Charles 92, Harold 120 back, Jimmy Curto or Miss Maria as our admin 121 back, and Logan back there 10th 140 back. And so there is your points coming into the night. What do you know? I actually got the points to work with the Crow's Nest. Go a figure. I worked on that last night and somehow managed to get it to give me the right points, to the best of my knowledge. So we're going to go green here in just a little bit. Just a little bit longer. Hey, Margaret. Hey, Marie. Hey, Becky. Hello. Hey, everyone in chat. As we're getting ready to go back green at flag racing for the Crow's Nest once again here tonight at Talladega. Well, 7 minutes remaining here, and we'll get ready to talk with your points leader here in just one moment. I mean, once again, I'll show them to you one more time. You got Dave Lane there and Michael Spell up in the front of the pack here. If anybody that didn't catch it, let's see if we can get a word with at least one of them. There they are in a room together. And let's grab Michael Spell first. Hey, Mr. Spell, it's Matt down here in the booth. You got a copy of your brother?
I do, sir. How's it going, man?
Going good, going good. Will you come in tonight, buddy? You're 22 points back. What are you thinking?
I hadn't even looked at the points today, so I thought I'd be further back than that. I think it's going to be a good race. I think we've got a good crowd. We got a lot of cars, so it's gonna be competitive for sure. So we'll see how it goes. I had a pretty good run here last night, so hopefully it spills over into today.
Alrighty, man. Well, best of luck to you out there tonight, Mr. Spell. You got two races left in the season, 22 points to make up. Definitely doable, and we'll see if you can get it done here tonight, buddy.
Yeah, we'll just put on our best show and see what happens.
All right, buddy. Good luck out there, Mr. Spell, and we'll see you at the end of it.
Sounds good, bud. Thank you.
I think their audio is a little bit low, so we're going to adjust that as we go to a quick commercial break. And when we come back, we'll get your interview with your points leader here tonight. Alrighty, folks, back here. Hope everyone's been having fun. As you can see, we're back here at the racetrack once again. And what we're going to do now is we're going to see if we can grab Dave Wayne right quick. Hey, Mr. Wayne, it's Matt up in the booth. You got a copy on it, brother?
I got you, Matt. How you doing tonight?
I'm doing good, bud. Well, you're coming into tonight with the points lead, my man. What's the plan to hang on to it here at the end of tonight and going into next week?
Well, I'm going to try to keep the car clean for at least 80% of the race. And it depends on where I am at the end, whether I race or just stay out of everybody's way.
Tempo on that, buddy. Well, best of luck to you going forward, my man.
Thank you, Matt.
Alrighty, man, Mr. Dave Lane here trying to hang on for a championship in the Chevy SS Series. Good luck to you, Dave.
Thank you again, Matt.
Alright, well, folks, there you have it. An interview with your top of two coming in tonight. Area 51, number 44 machine. Out there on the pit road right now. Well, before we go any further tonight, we're going to mute everything out because I've actually got a couple of announcements I need to make. So, all right. Announcement number one as it comes as follows. Extreme Sound TV will be headed to Watkins Glen tomorrow for the coverage of the Crow's Nest Super Late Model Series. At Watkins Glen, coming at you live tomorrow. If I'm not mistaken, 5:30 Eastern Standard Time. We'll be up at Watkins Glen there tomorrow night. I will be covering that one. Also, we have IR18s coming your way as well. I have that coming your way on Thursday, then back with Chevy SS on Saturday, and then Super Lates again next week, I think is how this is going to play out for us. So it'll be awesome in the meantime. Well, folks, I'm going to stand by with you right quick. And we're going to try something out here as a joke for certain somebody. So just stay with me here, and I'll be right back with you here on Extreme Sound TV. Okay, Hornet, you got to get out on track, buddy. You got to roll.
Mm.
There you go, the 007 machine of Mr. David Adamson out on track, otherwise known as Secret Agent Green Hornet, out on track here tonight. So let's take a look at your qualifying here, as we'll get the Secret Agent's time here. This is amazing. There we go. Secret Agent Man. Green Hornet. There you had it. That was about the craziest thing I've ever done. Oh, God. All right, that was a blast. I gotta say, qualifying underway here. We'll get the cars turned back on for you. That may have been the funnest thing I've ever done, to be honest. Well, Green Hornet out there on track, still rolling in that 007 machine. Out there on a track. Well, right now, Bud Steele on top of the leaderboard, as always. Nice run there for Bud Steele, Charles Johnson, right there as well. I told you over these next few weeks in the Crow's Nest, I've got some things coming. Little bit of surprises. There's more surprises where they that came from. Here tonight, believe you me. About 45 seconds to go here. I hope it don't block it on the replay of the race. I hope that the audio don't get blocked because of Secret Agent Man. I hope Green Hornet's able to see it. I know it'll be there on the live stream. I'm not quite 100% sure about the replay there. Give a shout out to the Hornet. Bud Steele out there on the front row as well. A couple cars not taking any time here tonight. I don't quite know why Secret Agent Man's time is not counting. I'm kind of confused. Cross the stripe one more time. Well, we will get ready here as we're getting ready for this one to kick off. Here tonight. Alright, here we go. Everything about ready to kick off. We'll get ready to look at your starting lineup here in just a moment. I need more monitors, honestly. Alright. Well, let's get ready here in just a moment to go through your starting lineup here in just 1 second. Alright, as we're going through the starting lineup for the Crow's Nest. Here we go, starting on pole here tonight. That is going to be Mr. Logan. The Crows are running wild here tonight. And as P3 Charles, Harold 4th, 5th goes Shane, Peter 6th, 7th goes to Stacy, 8th Kim Worley, 9th Art Peck, David Adamson, 10th. 11th, Darian. 12th, Jonathan Papa. 13th, Robbie. 14th, Dwight. 15th, Spell. 16th, Diego. 17th, Lane. And Jimmy Cruz. 18th, that is your admin for tonight. Tyler, 19th. Frank, 20th. 21st, Mike Morrison. Ron, 22nd. That's going to be your lineup here tonight as we hear the crows calling here on Extreme Sim TV, getting ready to go racing here tonight. Well, folks, the crows are definitely calling. If you hear them there in the back room, we're getting ready to go green flag racing here in just a moment. All right, there you have it, as we're getting ready to go green flag racing here tonight. Well, we're going to go green 100 laps here tonight. Well, Maria, what did you think about the crows during the pace lap as well? Something I thought about doing, hadn't got a chance to do it yet, but hey, we're doing crazy stuff tonight, so why not? And we will get ready to go green flag racing here in just a moment. All right, whenever they come out of turn at number four, we're going to turn on the loose here at Talladega Super Speedway and the Crows and Nest SS. That is crows, Miss Maria. That is the sound of crows. Well, some of them were crows. Look, I went with crow sounds, okay? I gave it a try. All right, here we go. I'm going to green here at Talladega Super Speedway. We are rolling with it as they come out of turn number four. Green flag will be in the air.
Green flag, green flag.
And our spotter lets us know we're rolling at Talladega Super Speedway. Everybody headed toward turn number one to get 100 laps here tonight. Gonna be a long one here tonight. One out of 100 in the books here as they come out of turn number two. See that area 51, 14, Christina Charles Johnson getting a shove on the outside. Dice run coming from behind him. Logan on the bottom there. He's got the 144 machine right there with them as well as they were working the inside of East Street too wide here at Talladega. Again, 100 laps here tonight. We get a break here. We'll show you the track data for tonight. Look at the track backstage at Talladega Super Speedway. 2.65 miles, 100 laps of distance tonight, or 265 miles. What they will run here tonight. And out front in that area in that area 51 machine, that is going to be Charles Johnson leading away. How are you doing tonight, Margaret? Everybody doing a great job here tonight in the line. Bud still in that area 51 machine on the high side, trying to get a shove. In fourth. Bud Steele trying to work his way up the street pack. Already the man of steel. Bud Steele doing a great job there in that 53 car working the outside as he comes up to the back bumper of Logan, giving Logan a nice shove in that corner. Nice job. Let's go take a look at the car for Art Peck here. As Art is back in the pack a little way, I ask him to do something for me. And there it is. Nice looking race car from Art Pack. Oh gosh, the chickens. Oh boy. Oh man, it's a chicken car. It's the chicken car. I think. Oh boy. Oh boy, it's the chicken car. Hard work in the outside lane. Well, I wanted to let everybody know, and it's an inside joke, the channel is now sponsored by WeBuyBackhoes.com and RentBackhoes.com. That's my new channel sponsor. To rent all your backhoes from backhoes.com. But yeah, that's my new channel sponsor. That mine. Inside joke for everybody here. Bud Steele, right straight to the race lead. Nice work job by Bud. Great job, side-by-side battle up front. Logan right there as well. Looks like we got one more coming on the outside. That's pretty Peter getting a shove as well. Peter, good shot, shove to the outside here. 5 of 100 complete. Nice shove to the outside. Charles, I've got to get back down the line. Along with Bud here. Try to work that inside. Area 51 on the bottom of the racetrack. You got representing Area 51 out front, Charles. Of course, everybody, Crow's Nest drivers, of course, Area 51 coming your way here in just a couple of weeks here on the channel. Those are some funky looking race cars, let me tell you. You got aliens on the hood and all kinds of crazy stuff going on. Thank you, Margaret. You got it. That's what counts. Everybody in the line, Charles Johnson right there as well. Doing a good job putting the back bumper to the 63 machine, pushing him up through the track. Margaret, explain it to her, please. You know, Maria, the other day, a couple of broadcasts ago, I dug myself a hole to China, and then I told you I had to rent a backhoe, take myself out of the hole. Get it, backhoerentals.com. Yeah. Buddy, nice in line, double file at Steel. 2x2x2, 10 cars deep. Buddy, side by side right now. I tell you what a show Bud Steel's putting on up there in that machine, able to hold the bottom, but it looks like the outside with Logan's going to prevail with Peter pushing him. Good run there. Good job by those two on the high side of the racetrack. 8 laps complete. Alright, everybody doing a great job. Logan immediately to the front of the racetrack, getting a big shove there from Bud Steele. Peter trying to follow his way through as well. Nice run, a side by side up front. 9 laps complete. The old mileage here tonight of stem fuel should be 32, I want to say, on the fuel before we start running into that problem. Again, 265 miles here tonight. Everybody just trying to keep their car nice and clean. 9 already in the books. And that outside lane and getting a good pull. Trying to pull that lane back up. Or heck, who's back there up there in that lane? Of course, the secret Green Hornet agent man person back here. in the back of the field, Mr. David Adamson. As always, in the back, hanging out like always. And then we'll see him at the end, charge his way through. He'll hit that secret agent spy tool. Get that car back to the front of the pack. Alright, a little bit of an announcement. Best place I can do it with the most eyeballs on it that I need to make an announcement right real quick as we're double file up front. Extreme Sim TV is in the process of getting Area 51 Extreme Sim TV shirts done. If you are interested in an Area 51 Extreme Sim TV shirt, please contact me or Miss Maria Crow. We will get that settled for you. I'm in the process of getting them designed right now, so let me know on that. Meanwhile, Logan leads the way. Doing a great job there in that 63 machine. Doing a great job keeping it under control. Logan out front, he's got Bud right there with him, Charles Johnson there as well, working the front of the pack. That Art said Stroker A's fastest kicking on my little Ruby. Man, that chicken better to go fast. Just say it. Now, still a double file up front. Everybody right on top of each other, doing a great job here, keeping it nice and clean at 13 complete. And a big hello to Senior, who's watching on the couch, drinking the RC Cola. Eating some popcorn and, you know, I don't know, Senior, what else you doing over there? You're not smoking, I don't think. You don't smoke, man. Help me out here, Maria. RC Cola, popcorn. Oh, get Maria to fix you a pizza there, Senior. Tell Maria to fix you a pizza right quick. Right now, everybody rolling the top side. Oh, it's Coke. Oh, man. I predicted that last week and it wouldn't. Hang on it. Hang on it, Singer. Stop smoking as I'm sitting here. Well, maybe I'm smoking myself, but that's not. Well, right now, Bud's still out front getting a big shove from Logan. Of 100 complete. And right now, look in the top four here, the 22 of Shane Hunter working his way up here as well. Of course, in the broadcast booth with me tonight, Mr. Raven, the lab dog that's looking at the screen like, what the heck? Who's your pick to win tonight, Raven? That's the cue for you to bark. It's not funny unless you bark. Oh, well, that didn't work. Meanwhile, up front, Bud Steele, Logan up there in the lead. We've seen that second line kind of peter off. They fell back a little bit. Peter back there. You've got Art as well up there on the high line trying to make it work in the fastest chicken in the world car. The fastest chicken, Art Peck, out there on track. We've got a secret agent man and the fastest chicken on racetrack right now at the chicken pit. Oh my God, Maria, you don't know who Stroker Ace is, and you don't know who Burt Reynolds is? Like, I thought all the girls liked Burt Reynolds. Like, when he was younger. I thought, like, he was a chick magnet. Oh God, here we go with the girlies. Tell you what. If I get 35 thumbs up on this video, if I get 35 thumbs up, I will make a video of me going to a nail salon and getting a pedicure and all that good nelly stuff. I'll even put a clear coat. I ain't putting fingernail polish on, but I'll put clear coat on. If you can get 35 likes, I will go to the nail salon and get a pedicure. That's all I want, 35 likes. You guys can do it. Well, right now, pretty much single file, and we've seen the same thing play out just a couple of weeks ago. Once they got single file and spread out, that was pretty much it. No, nails, not toes. Not toes, nails for real. Whatever it's called when you get your nails done, okay? Just that thing. I'm not a girl, I don't know the names for this stuff, but I will get my nails done and I will video it if this gets to 35 likes. I promise you, I will go do that. Well, pretty much single file, and here we go with the single file train. We've seen this before. Yes, and I will do it. I will do whichever it is. Okay, the fingernails, not the toes, the fingernail things. And I will pay the price if we get the likes. No, that's not as fun. I have to go to the actual store to do it, to make video on it, okay? We got a car out of line here. You've seen a car step out of line, but everybody pretty much single file here. Should be easing up to pit stops once again. Senior, you need to be in chat, dude. Need your back. Everybody pretty much single file, so what we're seeing, everybody getting in line, getting ready for the pit stops here at Talladega Super Speedway once again. I could get the girl, never mind. Not saying that. If I say that, she'll never let me down on it. Yes, I about got myself in trouble. The 53 car out front leading the way. Out 21 and complete, starting 22. Man, getting closer and closer to these pit stops. The buddy kind of staying in line here. Is exactly what I expected. And again, with them staying in line, what's going to happen is you'll get packs of cards hitting together here. And they'll try to break away to the other packs of cards to the 22 up to the top of the racetrack. He's just going to fall all the way back here. You see Logan and Bud staying in line up front. Alright folks, we're going to take a quick crank it up break here at Talladega Super. All right, as we had some a little bit of drama on pit road there during Crank It Up, we've seen everybody head down for their stops. A couple of cars got out of shape. We'll go back and take a look at it. As they were coming to their pit stall, look at this. The 14, it gets down. That's Charles there. Look at Bud. The 44 coming in pretty hot. Logan trying to hang on. Charles gets turned around. A couple of more in the grass. There's no caution. So that was not what they planned. Charles is going to have a lot of fighting back to do here from that little bit of a mistake here. Man. Again, coming out on track. That's going to split the field up quite a bit. Man, oh man. Well, Charles has got to be frustrated, but that's easy to have happen. Now we'll get him sorted back out. Worley and Logan's going to come out with the race lead. No caution. P6 complete. As we're about an hour worth of racing if this thing goes green here. Be over about 11 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Logan right there in the 63 machine. Right against Ken. Ooh, Logan blinking out there for a moment. He's 09 going a lap down up there. Ken right there as well. Nice run there for those two. Well, not really surprising here what this has turned into here. Turning quickly into what I kind of expected. A little bit of strategy and fuel mileage type situation. And we've seen this pretty much a couple weeks in a row here out of the Crow's Nest. When it comes to plate racing, you see that second back now closing the gap down. Logan's going to have to play defensively here if he's going to hang on to the lead. It's not going to happen. You see the big run on the outside. Three car tandem coming by. That's Bud Steele following Jonathan Papa and a Stacy to the lead. Nice job there. They're going to take back over the race lead. Everybody will pretty much single file out. Well, we got kind of interrupted. I was getting ready to do something new during that break, but getting pit stops kind of occurred. So once we get them sorted back out, we'll take another Crank It Up break here for a moment, and then I'll be back with you here in just a few minutes once we get everything sorted. Right back in line here. Everybody doing a great job up in front of the field, keeping it pretty much green for the first 30 here tonight. Well, folks, I'll be right back with you here in one moment. We'll be right back. All right, folks, sorry about that. I had to step away. No cautions, so I had to kind of improvise. But we are still going in green here in this front back, pretty nice and smooth. About seven cars are in that pack. Then you're back here to Arctic in the 36 machine, leading or pack number 2 and 8. And Peter right there with him, and then Shane as well. And then right behind them, you got Spell and Dwight Plesh in this little pack. Harold also back here with Tyler as well. The all of them spread out here. But Bud still sitting in second. We'll take a look at your points leader, Mr. Lane, if I can find him here. There he is, sitting in third. Lane opening up the gap on Spell. Exactly what he wants to do to keep extending that points lead. Perfect here plan for him. Exactly what he wanted to do coming into the night, I'm sure. I hope you're enjoying the show here on Extreme Sim TV. One man booth here tonight, so I had to step away and didn't really have anybody to feel for me. So back at it here, Jonathan Papa leading the way. Right now, Jonathan Papa leading the way. Yeah, it is. It's a really great race. Everybody doing a great job. No cautions. You see the Green Hornet up here in this pack as well. I still think before the Crow's Nest ends, Maria, you need to get up here in the booth with me one night. Have a little bit of fun. Hey Gary, good to see you in chat there as well. Jonathan Papa, Bud Steele leading the inside row. Now we're going to start to pull out of line, have a little bit of battle here. Jonathan Papa leading the way. Bud Steele right there as well. Look at the moves they're making. Big shove there for Steele. Big shove to the bottom. You got two cars on the high side trying to make it work all by them lonesome, all by themselves. That's Stacy there in the 24 machine. Logan in 63. Out of 100 complete here tonight. Everybody doing a great job keeping their cars in contained here tonight. And I expect one heck of a finish if we keep going the way we're going now. As we're about 23 laps on this stint. So before long, we're going to be headed back to pit road once again. You're doing a great job here. And an update from Bristol as well. Matt DiBenedetto leading the race by almost a second. How in the world is that even happening? Everybody doing a great job. Now Bud Steele right there on that back bumper of Papa. And these two have ran a lot together, so that experience paying off here, they're able to stay right with each other. And here we go, pit stops once again. Oh no, John locks the brakes up into the inside wall. And around him, oh, he's going to get it saved. Jonathan Papa, your race leader, into the inside wall. Dave Lane around here with Bud Steele. Now this group, you see a couple cars coming off pit road here. Lap number 50 stops are beginning again here. Man, oh man, this is crazy. Now we'll see this second group make their move onto pit road before long. Bud's going to stay out in an extra lap here. Man, oh man. So drama on pit road twice here tonight. Everybody out there doing a great job. We'll see if they come down pit road this time or not. And nice and easy does it. Everybody come down. Brocking the brakes up and nice job. And everybody nice and easy on the pit road. Bud Steele on pit road as well. Off of pit road once again. Of 100 complete here tonight. And Bud Steele out there in a second. He's a little bit of ways off the 11, but he's going to back up to Logan here. Ken still out there leading the way. Bud's going to back up to Logan. You got the Green Hornet, Secret Agent Man. We've seen him earlier in qualifying. His theme song played for him right now, running in fourth. Secret Agent Man himself. We don't know what's going to happen here on out with these strategies. At least one more pit, possibly two more pit stops coming up. And this thing has a green feel to it. To be honest with you, that they haven't lifted off that gas pedal the whole time. And Bud's still just knocking the laps down. Here they go. I'm about to put 53 in the books. Green flag back in the air once again. Or still green. It's not once again. Been green the whole way here. It's been awesome racing out there on the racetrack. Logan doing a great job. Now going to pull out of line. Try to make that move. Make that pass work. No help though. Here comes Hornet to the bottom. No big surprise there, Hornet to the bottom of the racetrack. And up to second, Secret Agent Man Hornet running second here. But he'll fall back in the line once again. Secret Agent Man. Dave Lane, Logan, also Ken Worley, Stacy, Jonathan Papa, all got there as well. Art Peck back here, the fastest chicken in the world, running in 8th right now. That chicken is fast, boy. The fast chicken, I'm telling you. Out of 100 in the books. Great racing out there tonight. Bud still leading the way here. Nice job from Bud. David Adamson right there with him. Well, see, that's what happens when I play songs, Margaret. You get stuck in people's heads. .58 to 100 completed tonight. Everybody, no cautions as of yet. Everybody's kept these cars pointed in the right direction. Right side up and pedal on the floor. Here, I'll sing it for you, Maria. Secret Agent Man. There you go. That's the worst singing ever. I need to make one for the broadcaster called Secret Agent Broadcast. Well, up front, as everybody's holding serve here, as they head back down the back straightaway here in single file line, this front pack, once again, pretty much holding serve. Well, we're going to drop back through the pack a little bit. Stacy back here in the second pack. Jonathan Papa, Art Peck. We see Jonathan lock the brakes up during that pit stop. Cost him some time. Doing a great job. Fastest chicken in the world trying to make up some ground. They're doing a great job out on track right now. Fastest chicken in the world out there. Great job. Everybody involved. I'm kind of watching this pack here, if you're wondering, see how they do at running the other packs down here. They've only got two cars. But hey, it is doable.
Street 2 feet wide, a son of a gun with a taste for fun and more than his share of pride. Take a dirt road curve with the devil's nerve, make a car dance across the mud, and haul and shine was his regular line till the track got in his blood. Was a real hot shot and he bragged a lot, but man, that fool could drive, cause he loved the feel of the steering wheel and the girls with the bedroom eyes. And in a racing tide or a barroom fight, old Stroker stole the show. A backstretch blazer, a real hell raiser, and a racetrack Romeo. Mama, lock your daughters up, that wild bunch is back in town. And them little girls get frisky when they...
There you go, Art. There you go, buddy. Some Stroker Ace. My, your wish is my command. Oh, man. We're having some fun with this tonight. Oh, man. I found it. I don't know how I found it. But I found it. Back to the race lead. Pack is heating up here. Bud Steele, Adamson, all up here in the front. Nice job as well. Well, what do you say? We've had theme songs. We've had all kinds of fun stuff tonight. And if the video or the band doesn't have any sound, we know why. Just know if the video, the replay of the race doesn't have any sound to it, that's probably why. But hey, we had some fun with it. Well. Out front still is Bud Steele. Now we're starting to get some racing for the lead here. A couple of two wide here. Sixty-five out of 100 laps complete here. And now I'm gonna have all these songs stuck in my head all night. I need to go watch Stroker Race now. That actually looks like a good show from what I've seen. That was the intro of the show, so I'm gonna have to watch it. Look at Bud Steele trying to hang on to the race lead. 65 out of 100 complete here tonight. Everybody 2x2 up front right now, and they are coming up on stint lap 15, so they're working their way through this stint here. We're just having a party here on Extreme Sim TV tonight, boys and girls and ladies. I'm not digging myself in that hole ever again. Well, two cars on the outside lane working together, trying to break themselves free here. Right now, a double foul it is. Dave Lane, look at him working his way up through there as well. Dave doing exactly what he needs to do. Dave Lane doing a great job. Yeah, let's see. Through the chat tonight, Becky, you will figure out when I'm doing broadcasts and talking to Maria and Margaret. I managed to get myself in trouble a lot, and I'm trying not to get myself in trouble tonight. I'm attempting anyway. And Bud Steele leads the way here. 69 complete, green flag all the way here tonight. Well, we're going to step aside for a quick commercial break, and we'll be back for the ending of this one at Talladega Super Speedway. Alright, we are back here. 70 complete. Everybody back in line. Bud still leading the way. Well, about 30 or so laps to go. David Adamson right there on the back bumper of Steele. Doing a great job here. They're doing a nice, smooth job out there, keeping it nice and clean. They're doing exactly what they need to do. Everybody has done a great job all night long keeping it clean and expect more of the same here. I don't expect to see any big problems. Nice racing out there right now. And I tell you what, Mr. Adamson is doing a great job keeping that car nice and clean the whole way. Setting in P number 2 right now. Out of 100 complete here tonight. Now 75 complete. As we're inching closer and closer to the end of this one. Yeah, Denny Hamlin did win. Mr. Hamlin did a great job. He got around Mr. Benedetto, but man, I wish the Benedetto could have held on, but that was... And here we go. Stop starting again. Secret Agent Man. Setting in second right now. I know, right, Bud Steele? And, well, we're going to do the game again. Who do you think is going to win the race? And you can't pick your significant other. That's the rule. You cannot pick your significant other. Remember the rules, girls, as I hit the pit road here. Nice and easy. Look at the Hornet. Easy does it. And what a good move by Hornet. He's going to pick up a couple of spots here coming to pit road. Great job by the Hornet. Great job by the Hornet. Oh, he went over the line just a little bit. He's going to have to back that car up. Of course, Margaret, you pick Bud. No, Maria, you cannot pick Bud. I said you can't pick your significant other. Never mind. Bud's not your significant other. Crap. Dang it, I left a loophole in the rule. Everybody, you pick who you want to pick. Dang darn it. Mess this up every week with you two. Exactly, so that's the point. You got around the rule because I said don't pick your significant other. Daggone it. I screwed up the ruling. Fine, you can have Bud and Margaret can have Hornet. Because I screwed up the rules again. Gosh, why is it when I'm dealing with women I screw the rules up? Well, there you have it. Adamson out front. He's got a little bit of a lead here. Man, oh man. What in the world, my phone just went goofy. Adamson out the front, leading the way. And Becky's going to go with Bud, too. Daggone it, everybody going with Bud. Bud's back to fifth right now. Trying to work his way back up towards the front. 78 out of 100 in the books. Bud's all by himself. Everybody's kind of spread out here. Oh, yep, that's Bud Becky. That would be Bud. In that Area 51 machine. Meanwhile, battle for the race lead. Here comes Logan with help with the 45. They're going to go to the outside. And there you have it. They're going to easily get by Adamson, or Secret Agent Man, as we like to call him. He had no help. Nothing he could do there. Just let him go by. Is that a 124 scale, Maria? That John's making. Is that a 124 scale car? Well, here we go, getting down to it here. The Hornet, they're in second, now able to take back over P2. Logan falling back a little bit. Definitely a... Just have him contact me. That'll be easier. Dave Lane out in a front. Now, Dave is your points leader coming in tonight, and he is doing a great job doing exactly what he needs to do here. Night team to go here tonight. Little pack of cars back here working their way down the back straightaway. 19 laps to go at Talladega. Dave Wayne up near the front here, just trying to hang on and have a good point set. Again, the season finale for these guys next week. And update for any Haley Deegan fans out there in the K&N West race. They have, looks like 20 to go, and Haley's running fourth. Yes, I'm a Haley Deegan fan, and I'm aware. I'm an awesome Haley Deegan fan. Getting a shove in there with Adamson, the super agent. Right there with him. Here comes the second group now. Bud Steele going to go to the outside with Logan. They're going to try to get a run here. Get by that inside lane. We're going to be very tight on the fuel here to the end if we stay green. I'm a secret agent, broadcaster. Buddy, side by side, 17 laps to go. So Maria's, Mr. Crow fell asleep yet while they're side by side. I figured it's probably about his bedtime by 11 o'clock. See, now I'm picking on Senior. Everybody side by side. With 16 laps to go. And we've seen this not too long ago, Bud and a Hornet fighting it out for the race win. Wasn't too long ago that we've seen this exact battle start to play out. And Bud's right back there as well, so. Nice and easy. Everybody's doing a great job here. Fifteen laps to go here. No cross. Senior's watching. All right. Senior, I love picking on you, buddy. Look at Hornet working his way up, trying to figure out something here. 14 laps to go. Hornet now is going to pull to the outside. Maybe looking to get it up in front of Bud. Get the shove from Bud Steele to help him through. Would not surprise me a bit to see that Hornet jump to the outside line with the 53 machine. 13 to go in this time by. Now you see that outside line making its move. Bud still leading that outside line down the back straightaway. They're going to pull even. They'll be even with Hornet now. Hornet can't make the move up. He's going to stay on the back bumper of Wayne. Really, the only choice he has now is to stay right there with Wayne. Doing a great job there around the bottom of the racetrack here. 12 laps to go. Oh man, it is getting tight up front with 12 to go here. Dicey Lane trying to make up his mind on what he wants to do. 12 to go as they come out of turn number 4. It'll be 11 to go here at Talladega. 11 laps to go. Let's say we do one more crank it up here, and when we come back, it'll be the end of this one. How are they? Right on top of the race lead. Coming to 7 laps to go. It's been green and flying all the way down at the front of straightaway here at Talladega Super Speedway. 7 laps to go here. Dave Lane out front. Hornet right there as well. Here we go. It is a battle here with 7 laps to go. The Hornet poking that nose right there on top of Dave Lane. Dave trying to hang on. Remember, he came in with the points lead here tonight. And he's got one more week coming next week. A win here would mean a lot to extend that points lead out just a little bit. And that's exactly what he is trying to do here tonight. The Hornet right there as well wants to grab a win. What about Bud Steele that's in the mix here? 6 laps to go this time by. Six to go. Now 5 next time by. Lane with the race lead. Hornet on the bottom. Steele now. Now they're going to be next to being 3 wide here. 5 to go at the stripe. It's shaping up to be a good one. What a race here tonight at Talladega Super Speedway for the Crow's Nest SS Series. Dave Lane out front. Bit 5 laps to go. And oh man, what a war hit it's been tonight. Four to go at the stripe this time. four laps to go. Dave Lane out front. Hornet right there with him. Can Hornet walk with him? Look at Logan up there in the top three. These cars have ran right together all race long. 14 lead changes. Fastest lap of the race. Way back on lap at number 22. Big move to the outside of the racetrack. Here we go. And a big shove coming on top of the racetrack. There's a good move from Bud. He's going to have help. Can he get clear? Three laps to go. Hornet on the bottom. Wayne there as well. Lane covering the bottom of the racetrack. Two laps to go. And Lane just maintained on the bottom. Three to go this time by. Now two to go. Lane up front. Hornet second. Steel is stuck in third. Next time by, we'll see the white flag. And it'll be one more time around in the Chevy SS Series. Here we go, one lap to go as they come back around. Who is going to put themselves in position? Spell back there in 7th in the 88 machine. He does not want to see Lane win this race, but there's nothing he can do to stop it. He's nowhere in the mix here right now. Back there around Art Peck, he's worked his way up to 6th, but they're not close enough to do anything about it. Here we go, coming to the white flag. Who is going to make it around one more time? Dave Lane, he's trying to win a championship. He's got to be careful here. He doesn't want to give up a bunch of points to Spell. He come in with a 22-point gap. Man, oh man, look at Bud Steele on the outside. Logan gets put in the middle. Bud's got to run on the top side of the racetrack. He's got help. Logan can't do nothing. He's going to fall back. Dave Lane trying to hang on. Now Bud down in front of Logan. Logan will come back to the back bumper of Bud. It's going to be a photo finish at the line. The Hornet right there as well. Out of turn at number 4. Here they come. Into the tri-oval. Bud Steele. They're going to make contact up front. Dave Lane hangs on. Through the tri-oval one more time. And at the stripe, Bud Steele wins it by the nose over Dave Lane. Dave, though, with a great points day. Congratulations, Bud Steele. Steele gets the win here tonight. What a race. Great job, Bud Steele. We'll get a word with him here in just one moment. Bud Steele, your race winner here tonight. Congratulations to Bud. Hey, Bud Steele, it's Matt up here in the booth. You got me, brother?
Whew, I got you, Matt.
Well, congratulations, buddy. You edged Dave Lane out for the win. That little bit of contact, I think, may have slowed Lane down just a little bit there and helped you there on the outside lane to come on through.
I didn't know if, I hope I didn't come down on him. I thought maybe he drifted up, but... That was a great last lap there. There was no passing on that outside unless you had three cars. And trying to side draft, tried everything.
All righty, man. Well, great run to the finish and another win for Bud Steele, man.
Yeah, one more. Thank all the Crow's Nest guys and Marie, Jimmy Senior, Jimmy, everybody. It's a nice race. Another caution-free race, 2 weeks in a row.
Yeah, another one, and it was a good race overall, man. It really was.
Well, I hope everybody enjoyed it.
All righty, bud. Well, congratulations, buddy.
Thanks a lot, man.
All righty, man. Well, we'll see you there in the next one, bud.
Yes, sir.
All right. Let's see if we can grab your points leader, Mr. Wayne, if he's still in here. Hey, Mr. Wayne, it's Matt up in the booth. You got a copy?
Yeah, I've got you, Matt.
Well, buddy, you missed out on it by inches, man.
Yeah, that bud, he's a tough customer.
For sure. Looks like y'all made a little bit of contact coming through the tri-oval, and that just slowed your car down just enough that Bud could get the momentum and power around on the outside.
Yeah, I went back and looked. It was probably me pushed up just a little bit.
All righty, man. Well, congratulations on P2 and extending your points lead here tonight, man.
Well, thank you, Matt. I hope you viewers liked the race.
I think we all had a good time tonight, man. It was a good race, a lot of fun. Got some surprises in the broadcast. Whenever you guys go back and watch it, you'll find it entertaining. So, it should be a good night, good fun, and congratulations.
Yeah, that was caution-free, too, wasn't it? That was a good race.
Yep, it was. It was caution-free all the way through, buddy.
All right, Matt. Thank you.
All righty. Congratulations there, Dave.
Yeah, thanks. Have a good night, Matt.
You too, buddy. And we'll grab third place. Mr. Logan making it in the top three here. Hey, Logan, it's Matt up in the booth. You got a copy?
Yes, I do. How are you?
Doing good, buddy. Well, you snuck it through. Got it in the top three here tonight, buddy.
Yeah, that was a really fun race. At least this time it didn't ruin my pit stop like almost every single other Saturday race.
Great. That's always a positive, man. Nice, clean pit stop to come through it pretty clean. You're going to come home third. A pretty good night there for that 63 car for Mr. Logan.
Yep. And this, even though my pit stops weren't necessarily the fastest, it kept me up front. And that was my main goal. Just don't risk anything, and hopefully it works out.
Yeah, you did a great job there, man. Our green flag stops went pretty smooth for you. Well, buddy, yeah. I'll tell you what, it's always fun watching you guys out there. You did a great job bringing her home third. Anybody you'd like to thank right quick?
I'd like to thank Bud. All the Area 51 teams, team members, Last Lap Motorsports or Checkered Flag Motorsports are going through a name change. Parents for letting me race this late, grandparents for watching, and yeah.
Alrighty, man. Well, have a good one there, Logan.
Thank you. And do you mind if I do a little advertisement thing real quick?
Go for it.
Make sure to go on Facebook and look up LKH Racing number 63 team and make sure to like the page. I'll be putting all my go-kart stuff on there.
Alrighty, buddy. Alrighty, man. We'll see you in the next one, Logan.
Yep. Or not next Saturday. Got the go-kart race, but yeah. Thanks for putting on the broadcast.
Alright, buddy. We'll see you in the next one, my friend.
Bye.
Well, folks, we got one more interview if he's still in here. Mr. Spell, you got a copy on my brother. He probably wasn't planning on getting interviewed. I did this to him last time. We're going to give him a minute and see if we can get a hold of him. Because last time he won a race, I tried to grab him for an interview, couldn't grab him. This time he finished fourth and wasn't expecting to get an interview or finish. I got to double check my score in there. I probably wasn't expecting to get an interview, so we're going to see if we can get a hold of him here. We'll give him a minute. Do-do-do, waiting on Mr. Spell. See if Spell comes back. He's going to be like, what? I'm on air? All right, well, we will see if we can get poor Spell in the next one. Folks, we're going to go through your finishing order here. Unofficial race results: Steele, Wayne, Logan, Adamson, Worley, Peck, Spell, Clash, Papa, and let's double check 24th on back. I always do that to make sure everything's right here. And like I thought, it was kind of broken. So the 24th being scored in 10th, I'm not completely sure. But we'll let it scroll through here on back. What it's saying, kind of broken back here for whatever reason, but other than that, it's been a great night of broadcasting. Don't forget tomorrow night, Crow's Nest. Okay, if I can speak right, Crow's Nest Super Late Model Series Watkins Clan action coming your way here, and we will be covering that one as well. Until then, stay safe. God bless and have a great night. And don't forget, Secret Agent Man. We'll see you in the next one. You're on Extreme Sim TV.